Hi guys, it's Sammy here. Today I want to talk about the law of ordinances versus the law of liberty. The law of liberty, also known as the moral law. A lot of people say that because we are under grace, we don't need to obey the Ten Commandments. It seems like they're a bit confused between the Mosaic law and the law of liberty. The Mosaic law, the law of Moses, is the law of ordinances, and the moral law is the law of liberty. Well, let's go to scripture. A lot of people say they use Colossians chapter 2 verse 14 to 17 to say that we don't need to. This is specifically with the Sabbath commandments. For some reason, a lot of people just, you know, they just hate the fact that every single commandment is to be obeyed. So they think that because the law of ordinances also included Sabbath days and all that, they think that refers to the weekly Sabbath, but that actually refers to the yearly Sabbath and the monthly Sabbath. That is, they had to have Sabbath like on the seventh month of every year, and they had to have Sabbath every 7 years. So that's different from the weekly Sabbath, which is part of the Ten Commandments. The other Sabbath, which also included feast and other things, were part of the law of ordinances. But let's see what Colossians says. Colossians 2:14-17 says, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross, and having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. Let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink, or in respect of an holy day, or of the new moon, or of the Sabbath days, which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ. Make note that it says that all these things were a shadow. So the law of ordinances was a shadow for things to come. Because God did not delight in their ordinances, because the blood of, you know, they were sacrificing goats and all these things, doing all these things to atone for their sins. But God did not delight in it because it was temporary. It covered their sins, but it did not wash away their sins. It was just a cover. So it was not permanent. So therefore, they had to keep doing it every year. Every year, they had to keep doing it. You know, the priest had to keep going into the tabernacle and all that to do the oblations and stuff. But the book of Isaiah shows us that God did not delight in these things, and that's why God abolished it when he died on the cross, because Jesus is God in the flesh. So when he died on the cross, this is what he abolished on the cross. This is what he nailed to the cross. Isaiah chapter 1 verse 13 to 14 says, bring no more vain oblations. Bring no more vain oblations. Incense is an abomination unto me. The new moon and Sabbath, the calling of assemblies, I cannot away with. It is iniquity, even the solemn meeting. Your new moons and your appointed feasts, my soul hated, and they are a trouble unto me. I am weary to bear them. So God did not like these ordinances. They were not enough. You see? They were not enough to completely wash away the sins of the people. And Colossians 2:14-17 is talking about these ordinances. It has nothing to do with the Ten Commandments at all, the law of liberty. It has nothing to do with that. Hebrews chapter 10 verse 1-4 also confirms this. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, and not the very image of the things, can never, with those sacrifices which they offered year by year, continually make the commands thereunto perfect. Let me repeat that. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, and not the very image of... You see, the law of ordinances was just a shadow of the things to come, as it says in verse 1 here, and in verse 17 of Colossians 2. So, because Jesus Christ was the very image of those things, there was no more need for the shadow of those things. So, they had to be done away with because the very image had arrived. So, you can see why the law of ordinances was abolished. Verse 2, for then would they not have ceased to be offered, because that the worshippers once purged should have had no more conscience of sin. But in those sacrifices there's a remembrance again made of sins every year. See that? For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and goats should take away sins. So like I explained earlier, this was why Jesus had to come and die, because his blood, because he's God, his blood was the only perfect blood, is the only perfect blood rather. So God himself had to come and shed his own perfect blood, because flesh and blood is flesh and blood and the blood of animals. Like it's not enough. The blood of animals is not enough, and flesh and blood keep sinning. Like it wasn't enough to cover their sins. So it took the perfect blood of Jesus himself to do away with those ordinances. So after Jesus Christ did away with those ordinances, he gave us the grace to keep the Ten Commandments. I'll talk about this further in the next video.